السلام على مريم. الحمد لله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، وبعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Tonight بإذن الله تبارك وتعالى, the night of the 14th of the month of Muharram 1439, after the hijra of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين, we are continuing the reading of this book that is mulakhas al-fiqh, المُلَخَّصَ الْفِقْهِ بَيْ شَيْخ صَالِح الْفَوْزَان حَفِظَهُ اللَّهُ وَرَعَاهُ, with the complimentary notes from Al-Wajiz, with the complimentary notes in Al-Wajiz. And we were still reading in regard to the Salatul Witr, the Salatul Witr, and the conclusion tonight بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى, it is to mention after briefly mentioning about the witr, the ahkam, the ruling of it, and the kayfiyati, meaning how to make the witr. We mentioned that the witr could be made in 11 rak'at, 13 rak'at, 9 rak'at, 7 rak'at, 5 rak'at, 3 rak'at, wa aqalluha wahid, and the least that a person can make a witr with is one raka'ah. Tayyib. So we mentioned about how to do the 11 raka'ah. There is two ways of making the 11 raka'at. Misha see?
You can pray 10, and then you can pray 10, you do the
تشهد أيوة سلام أيوة التسليم أحسنت. The number one is that you can pray 10 rak'ah straight, sit down, make tashahud, get up and bring the 11th rak'ah, sit down, make the tashahud, and say taslim. Ahsanta. What is the other way? Ahsanta. You can pray all 11 with one single taslim. Which one is better? The first one, the one that he said. Barakallahu fiqh. Tayyib. So in regard to the nine raka'ah tashahud, Ismail. In regard to the 9 raka'ah tashahud, Sulaiman, how do you do the 9 raka'ah tashahud?
You can pray all the 8 together and make one witr.
Ahsanta, you pray all the 8 raka'ah together and then sit down
and get up
and get up
and make,
make one witr and sit down, so it is only one.
Tashahud.
Very good. So likewise, the 7 and the 5, it is the same. The 7 and the 5, it is the same. Based on the hadith. Man, barakallahu fiqh. You OD today. Tayyib, as in regard to the 7 and the 5, that the hadith, where the hadith of Ummu Salama, where the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as our mother Ummu Salama mentioned, she said that the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yuwatir bi sab'in wa khamsin la yufassil baynahunna bi salamin wa la kalamin. That the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will pray witr with 7 or 5, and he will not make no distinction between them, meaning he will not pronounce the salam between them, meaning between the raka'at, nor he will be saying no statement between the raka'at. So that shows that it is all together 5 or 7 raka'at straight, with only one taslim. وَقَدْ بَيَّنَا, and this is, inshallah ta'ala, reading back the al-mulakhas al-fiqhi. وَقَدْ تَبَيَّنَا مِمَّا مَرَّ أَنَّ ذَلِكَ أَنَّ لَكَ أَن تُوَتِّرَ بِإِحْدَى عَشَرَ رَكَعَاتٍ. He say, as what we have mentioned, we read, is that it is possible that you make a witr with 11 rak'at, or 13, or 13 rak'at. وَبِسَبْعٍ, or وَبِتِسْعٍ, or with 9 rak'at, وَسَبْعٍ, or 7 rak'at, وَبِخَمْسٍ, or with 5 rak'at, or 3, or 3 rak'at, وَبِرَكَعَةٍ وَاحِدَة, or even 1 rak'at. It's very possible. Now, فَأَعْلَى الْأَكْمَالِ إِحْدَى عَشَرَة. Now, the most complete way to do it, and the highest level, the highest number, and the most complete one is 11 rak'at. وَأَدْنَى أَكْمَلْ, and the least complete is 3 rak'at, is 3 rak'at. So the most complete number is 11 rak'at, and the least complete number is 3 rak'at. وَالْمُجْزِئُ رَكَعَةٍ واحد. But if one pray only one rak'ah, he will be rewarded, but it is not the most complete one. The least complete is 3, the most complete is 11. But if one pray only one rak'ah, he will be rewarded. The least complete is Hassan. Ahsanta, the least complete is 3. The highest complete is 11. And one is?
One
rak'ah. Is what?
Is rewarded.
Ahsanta, and one is rewarded. So here it is important to see these terms. The most complete is 11. The least complete is 3. And one is rewarded. One is rewarded. So if one, barakallahu fikum, pray one, his reward will not be the same as the one that pray 3. But the one that pray 3 has prayed the least complete. If one pray 11, he has prayed indeed higher than the one that pray 3. So the highest complete is 11. The least complete is 3. And one rak'ah is being rewarded as praying witr. وَيُسْتَحَبُّ لَكَ, and it is something, and inshallah this is what we want to dwell in today, in tonight. وَيُسْتَحَبُّ لَكَ أَن تَقْنُتْ بَعْدَ الرُّكُوعِ فِي الْوِتْرِ, and it is recommended that you perform the qunut. It is recommended that you perform the qunut. He say بَعْدَ الرُّكُوعِ فِي الْوِتْرِ, after the ruku'u, during the witr. So remember, the witr is the last rak'at. So it is recommended to make the qunut in the last rak'ah after the ruku'u. After the ruku'u. He say, بِأَن تَدْعُ اللَّهِ, it is that you supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَتَرْفَعَ يَدَيْكَ, that you raise your hands, طيب, that you raise your hands, وَتَقُولُ اللَّهُمَّ اهْدِنَا فِي مَنْ هَدَيْتَ إِلَىٰ آخِرِ, and you say the dua, اللَّهُمَّ اهْدِنَا فِي مَنْ هَدَيْتَ وَعَافِنَا فِي مَنْ عَافَيْتَ وَتَوَلَّنَا فِي مَنْ تَوَلَّيْتَ إِلَىٰ آخِرِ. طيب. So that saying of the qunut al-witr, it is not restricted to only in Ramadan, but rather it is during the whole year. It is during the whole year. It is not restricted to only in Salatul Taraweeh in the month of Ramadan. Naam. Ahsanta. He say, is the qunut the same dua or different dua? The most authentic one, the strongest one, is this dua. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt, from the dua of Hassan ibn Ali. Hassan ibn Ali was the brother of Hussein ibn Ali, right? And they are both what?
Twins.
No, they're not twins. They're not twins. No, they're not. The sons. Sons.
Sorry, the sons of
Ali. Right.
Father of Ali.
Yes, Ali is their father. Very good. No, they're not twins. A lot of people, they think. Yes, grandsons. Grandsons. Give him a cup of tea. Grandsons. No, they're not twins. See, us, we think that Hassan and Hussein, they are twins. That's why when people have twins, they always name them Hassan and Hussein. Right? Like Hassan and his brother. No, they're not twins. They're not twins. I believe that Hassan is older than Hussein. Ma'adhira, Hussein is older than Hassan. Hussein is older than Hassan. They're not twins. They're not twins. One is older than the other one. But we thought meaning some people, they think that Hassan and Hussein, they're twins. That's why whenever they have twin boys, they name them Hassan and Hussein. Ain't nothing wrong about naming Hassan and Hussein your twins. But thinking about that, if you have twins, you automatically got to call them Hassan and Hussein. This is not something that is established. Even though it is good to name after your children Hassan and Hussein. Why? Because they are Sayyida Shabab Ahlul Jannah. They are from the leaders of the youth of the Jannah. So what a better name to give your child. From the leaders of the youth of the Jannah. That's why it is important to choose one's name. It is important to choose the name that you give to your child. Walillah alhamdu wal minna, the name has an effect on a person. Marhaban. We'll come to those details, inshallah. We have a lot of details in the Qunun, but inshallah we'll present. Jazakallah khair.
Can you repeat the dua, please?
The dua is a little long. If you want to write it down, I can give it to you, right? Naama, somebody else raise their hands. Hassan, what were you saying again?
What I've been hearing is there's a Prophet
Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Ali Salatu Salam.
Ali Salatu Salam was sitting down, they come, they say, Fatima give back your name, but he said Al Hassan. Then after they went home, they come back, they say, oh, he has another one, he said Al Hussein. So they say in Arabic mean good, like Hassan means good, Al Hussein, that means both of them good.
No, that's not the truth. This is what is the truth. When Ali radiyallahu anhu has a baby, his first baby, he came to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and told him, Ya Rasulallah, I have a boy and I name him Irhab. I named him Ma'adhira. In the sense of war, this is what he named the son of, war. Huh? Harb, yes, Harb. I'm saying Irhab because it's the same word. He named it Harb. We mentioned this before, right? He named it Al-Harb, meaning war. Why? Because Ali was a very brave person. Whatever a person is, this is...